The next speaker is John J. Sweeney, AFL-CIO from Boston. John was presented today with the INCORE Global Peace and Social Justice Award, which he received earlier from the University of Ulster in recognition of his contribution to peace and social justice. John Sweeney Achara. Thank you, John.
Thank you very much. I'm delighted to have this opportunity to address this outstanding audience and why we're all here together. To Senator Murray and all of the guests who are here, to Tom O'Neill and all the O'Neill family, and Mr. Crossan, Mr. Campbell, and Mr. Neely, and of course, John Hume. It is very special to be with you all tonight in beautiful County Donegal, and to be in the company of so many natives of this great country. Donegal has sent so many to us, sons and daughters, to the United States, and to my native New York in particular. And that it's special to be here tonight with my friends, including President Michael Higgins, who will be joining us, and who is highly regarded in the United States as a scholar, as well as head of state of the Republic of Ireland. And with Senate President Theresa Murray of the Massachusetts Senate, recipient of the 2014 Tip O'Neill Irish Diaspora Award. Friends, diaspora is an award that has come more into focus in recent years, thanks to our Jewish brethren across the world. As for the Irish, we know from our own often painful, dredging events and our diasporan experience has been part of a journey of survival. There is as little need for me, a proud descendant of people from County Leitrim, to recant for my friends here in County Donegal litany of how harsh that journey was for the hundreds of thousands who went before us from these parts, or how cruel and inhumane conditions drove people from their homeland. Senator Murray also knows the story of the Irish well herself, with her roots from Kerry to Limerick. My own journey as part of the Irish diaspora in America is thanks to my parents and gave me the privilege of working for the women and the men, all races and ethnic backgrounds throughout my career. As president in the labor movement in New York, one union in particular was the Service Employees International Union. And as a leader of the American labor movement, as president of the AFL-CIO, I saw firsthand that what we were able to accomplish was tied to the legacy of the man for whom this award was named. Speaker Thomas P. O'Neill, the labor movement still owes much to his legacy and his decency and commitment to fairness for people. The Tip O'Neills were indeed part of that diaspora journey from Buncanum. And to Tip O'Neill, his credit, he never forgot the journey, nor did he ever stop fighting for the right of human dignity for all. This was just not in terms of the landmark legislation he supported, steered to passage, but over in the areas of affordable housing, voting rights, and equal opportunity in employment, and also his basic sense and caring for people as human beings. I first met Speaker O'Neill during my days as president of the Service Employees International Union and worked closely with him in Washington. Tip O'Neill was always accessible to me and others and made sure that working men and women from every neighborhood in America had a chance for a better life. As chairman of the AFL-CIO Housing Investment Trust, our effort to build more and better housing for many thousands of Americans was made possible in part in the Housing and Community Development Act of 1974, of which Tip O'Neill was a leading supporter. The leadership provided then by Tip O'Neill helped us to grow an asset base for the Housing Investment Trust that stands at nearly $5 billion today, with more than $1.3 billion of affordable housing financed in Senate President Murray's own state of Massachusetts. Tonight, I extend my sincere congratulations to Senate President Murray, who was a daughter of Ireland and friend of workers. I want to thank you all for asking my wife Maureen and myself to join you for this special evening. It was a great credit to you that President Higgins was able to join us or will be joining us. And so I just say, thank you to all of you for all that you do, and God bless you for all that you have done. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, John. Wonderful words. And there is a special presentation of our Donegal prayer to John by the mayor.